With the McCombs Plan, there are four main components. The first component that we consider is the dietary program. On the McCombs Plan, you can have all meats except for pork, fish, chicken, turkey, beef, buffalo, all vegetables, all fruits, eggs, tea, coffee, and brown rice. And brown rice is the only grain. Brown rice either as plain rice, plain rice cakes, or hot brown rice cereal. Now, the one thing to note here is that with the traditional Candida plans, which have been around for quite a few years, is that they try to starve Candida out of the body, which is nearly impossible. So they don't allow you to have fruits or starchy vegetables like potatoes. And those are allowed on the McCombs plan. And why is simply because we found that when you take the supplements and follow the plan as outlined, you can have fruits. It wasn't a factor. If you look at the reality of the situation, Candida doesn't really need any food. There's no way you can really starve it out of the body. Candida can lay dormant in the body. It has that ability. Candida can derive all of its nutrients from all the cells and tissues in the body. It doesn't need to look outside of the body for a source of nutrients. So why does anyone need to use a diet at all if Candida has this amazing ability to derive all its nutrients from the body? Simply that there are certain forms of sugar which will enable the Candida to spread very quickly, very rapidly, and keep the Candida growth going at a rapid pace. Candida grows very rapidly, dies off rapidly, so it constantly creates its own toxicity within the tissues from this constant die-off. But it doesn't need much food. But we don't want to assist that process. And what we found is if you give it these extra foods which contain sugars, for instance, whether it's white sugar, brown sugar, honeys, syrups, etc., all these will feed Candida. Also, simple carbohydrates will break down very quickly in the blood to sugar. So these will also propagate the growth of Candida, the fungal form, throughout the body. So it's not that you can starve it, but what you don't want to do is facilitate its growth and impede the efforts to get rid of it. So along with the foods that you can eat, you know, you can also have any seasonings as long as there's no sugar, yeast, or dairy. The second part of the McCombs plan is that there are three products that we give you which help in the elimination of fungal Candida, boosting the immune system, and the restoration of normal tissue flora. The first of these products is Candida Force, which is an undecanoic acid product. Undecanoic acid is a fatty acid which is derived from castor bean oil. It's this fatty acid which is assimilated into the cell wall membrane of the fungal form of Candida, which causes it to revert back to its yeast form in a slightly weakened state. Now that we have it in its weakened state, what we want to do is boost the immune system. We do that through our second product, Detox Essentials. Detox Essentials contains C, echinacea, red clover, and bioflavonoid. This helps to boost the immune system, especially a specific part of the immune system, such as neutrophils, which are most effective in getting rid of the excess yeast. The third product is our Flora Prime, which is a probiotic. As we had talked about earlier, antibiotic means against life, probiotic is for life. So probiotic organisms are organisms which have demonstrated an ability to improve the health of the digestive tract. Our Flora Prime contains 12 different strains which fulfill that role. Now the first two products you start at the beginning of the plan, the Flora Prime isn't added into the plan until you reach week 7. The reason why we have you hold off is we want to get rid of the Candida and create space for this Flora Prime to really implant itself and establish itself within the ecosystem of the digestive tract.